Hi there again. I had an interview at Park Florence. As we speak, I'm here at the Stansted Airport, so it's a nice environment to look back at my interview at Park Florence. I had the interview with Niels. He's the founder of the company. Niels has a background in hospitality. And when he was on holiday, he had two bad experiences. The first was, okay, he had really high parking costs at Schiphol Airport, Dutch airport near Amsterdam. Other question was, okay, and then I arrived at my destination. I was here going to Corsica or whatever. And he had a really bad customer experience at the car rental company because he really felt as he was a number and he didn't experience any service at all. So he was thinking, okay, there's a really strange thing when you look at airports. At one side, there are thousands of parking places full of cars waiting for their owner coming back from holiday. At the other side, you get hundreds of parking places with cars of car rental companies waiting for tourists to arrive to be rented. So he was thinking, okay, can I do something about it? And then he invented a car rental company without owning any car. It's a model is like, okay, you're going on holiday, you're going to park your car at their office near the airport, Schiphol Airport. They are going to bring you in your own car to the airport. Then during your holidays, they will rent out your car to other people. And when you arrive back home, you have no parking costs. And parking costs are at maximum at Schiphol Airport, €75 a week. Your car is cleaned. And last but not least, when they manage to rent out your car during your holiday, you will also share in the profits. So it's a really nice concept. Because the car rental company market is really stuck. About 80 or 90% of all the car rental company markets is managed by four big companies, and they really are focusing on one thing: price, or price and price. So there, all the user experience, all the hospitality, everything is cut out just to make a really effective company that is only focusing on price. And the good thing about, I'm looking also down because there are my notes. So at one side they have two target groups. One is the owners of the cars, so they come to the airports and they leave their car with them and their profits by not paying the parking costs, having a clean car, and maybe also profits from you renting out the car. At the other side, the car renters, so the tourists, because they pay at least minus 30% of the average rates of cars being rented by a car rental company. When you leave your car over there, it's fully insured, so when anything happens, everything will be arranged. It's also really interesting for corporate businesses, because like when you as a business traveler travels about 40% of your time through over the world, you will save at least €4,000 each year. But they are now working together with one company, but it's quite hard because also lease cars are not allowed to share on car sharing platforms because of the lease contract. So you really have to negotiate as a company with your lease company that they're going to change it. In the end, they want to be a market leader in Europe in the car sharing and car renting business near airports in 5 years. So they got great ambitions. They're going to enter the next country this year with 4 or 5 main airports in one time. So at the end, they want to realize an ecosystem where you go from Schiphol to Malta and then you leave your car at Schiphol at Park Florence, and at the end at Malta you will pick up a car of Park Florence. So there will be less cars needed for the travel industry. I think it's a great idea. It's got some challenges, I guess, in the future, because first they're really focusing on the parking costs, and they say, okay, Schiphol advertises with a really low parking cost rate, and in practice you will have to pay much more. I think they are advertising with the highest Schiphol parking car rate, because there are also some really nice other alternatives when you want to pay less for parking, like going by public transport. Like in Ireland, it's really good to go by public transport to the airports, or there are also some other ways where you can also lower the costs. Like there are some initiatives where you can park at a farm, and then the farmer will bring you to the airport. So they're not the only player in this market. Second one is they don't have a CTO. They are outsourcing all their all the developments. And the answer of news on that question was, okay, but we're not a technical company, but we are a hospitality company. And I think partly he's right, but at the end, the usability of the platform is also really important. And as we also learned with Snapcar, they really regret not having a CTO from the start. And in the end, also, when you look at the website of Parkfly Rents, it's really a traditional car rental company. And that's also, I think, some challenge for the future, because they're now positioning quite traditional in the market. And I think they can take more advantage of their disruptive model, but not too much, because else then the customer, they won't understand it. And then they say, okay, I'm going to play it unsafe and I will go hire a car at a traditional car rental company. They now get one investor. They don't make use of any subsidies of whoever. So I think it's really cool. But also, when you really want to expand and be the market leader in 5 years in Europe, they would need quite some money to make it happen. And also, when you look at the team right now, it's a quite a young team, and I'm really I'm curious about how they can manage the growth of the company being a market leader in 5 years. On the other side, I think the concept is great, so it got lots of potential, but I'm really looking forward on how they're going to tackle the challenges I just mentioned.